Hello everyone, welcome to Dragon Age. My name is Jayvan, and I'm here playing, well, Dragon Age, duh. But, just to let you all know, I woke up from a dream that I had, and I thought I was pretty freaked up, regardless. Save these guys. Came to see what they had.
Hello.
The boy's a bit simple, but he's rather good with enchantments. One of those tranquil fellas actually called him a... what was it now? A savant. I had no idea such a thing existed.
Yeah,
he can fold lyrium into almost any weapon or piece of armor. Though naturally some of the more extravagant materials will take more lyrium than others. It's a process that some of the master smiths back in Orzammar will perform, but my boy here is just as adept at it. Isn't that right, boy?
Enchantment!
And there you have it.
Man, he seems so excited for enchantment. Gosh dang it. Whoa. I completed a quest? Whoa. Nobody said I wanted a quest. Bandits on the road. Fallen Templar. Sir Daniel through the fallen knight, Henry. Locking in the note. You released him from his cage and he agreed to follow you. Okay, honestly, guys, in all seriousness, please post below and see, like, if I'm tips and tricks about certain, you know, whatever. The missionary discovered Rigby's meeting point and found a note and a small cache of goods, but no sign of Rigby. The last will and testament. More pressing matters have taken you from the Krokari Wilds. Ostagar, joining the Great Wardens. Oh, those are completed. Okay, regardless. Let's see, current quests. Skill with herbs to craft some lesser health. Okay, guys, I know this is going to sound really stupid, but in the comments below, please post tips and tricks of where I could do that. And for the Blight, seek out Arl Amon. In the Battle of the Blight, you need to travel deep underground in Dwarven City. Mages. Okay, if you guys seriously have any tips and tricks about, like, who to look for, or whatever hoopla-pla, then please post in the comments. And if you know me in real life, tell me what. Just go ahead and straight up say, hey, go this route. Frick off.
If there's anything I can do for you, please tell me.
Have you heard any rumors?
I hear news from Dinarum that Tyrn Loghain has been declared the new regent. It makes sense, his daughter being the queen. That's what I've heard on the road, anyhow. Take it for what it is.
So what's your story exactly?
I suppose since you told me about you being a Grey Warden, it's only fitting for me to be as open. I am originally from Orzammar, the famed dwarven city that lies beneath the stately Frostback Mountains. I was a merchant there, too. Merchant caste. These things are in the blood, you know. You can't just leave them behind. I ran a fairly successful business. Rare artifacts, you know. Old things, grand things. The nobles loved them. Reminded them of the lost glory days, I suppose.
Lost glory?
Our kingdoms once spanned the length of Thedas, from majestic Orzammar to Cal Shirok to glittering Darmalin far to the west. They say the gold and silver veins ran so thick through the stone of Darmalin that the entire city sparkled. The Darkspawn took it all, of course. One by one, the old Tigs fell, and then all that was left was Orzammar. But we were talking about how I ended up here, weren't we? One day, a noble woman came to my stall. She looked around for a bit and then started shrieking in dismay. Apparently, she believed that a pair of braces I had for sale once belonged to her brother. He'd been lost in a cave-in, you see, while on an expedition to clear out the Darkspawn from one of the tunnels running close to the city. They were made specially for him. They're unique, she shrieked. He stole them from my poor brother's corpse. She had me arrested on the spot, of course. Nobles, they're touchy like that.
It almost sounds like... Were you... And you stole them?
Well, I didn't steal them. You see, I'd been paying these castless thugs to venture out into the deep roads for me. The Lost Tigs. They're full of things that people left behind. Sometimes you can find a treasure. Something worth a little gold. To the nobles it is. They believe everything in the Tigs belongs to the house that once dwelled there, even if it's in ruins and they haven't seen it in generations. The noblewoman, she wasn't too happy with the theft of her brother's braces. I don't know what they planned for me, and I didn't want to find out. Bribed the guard that was watching me and took off for the surface first opportunity I got. Huh. Never looked back.
So, you basically... Isn't that kind of shady business? I would think it is. Yeah, you quite like to have done so.
I thank the stone every single day. Now, is there anything the boy or I can get you? Look, we don't rob people, all right? We don't take things from people that need them. The things in the Lost Tigs, what good did they do lying there? I brought them back to Orzammar, where people could look at them and remember. It's not all that different up here. There are places long abandoned by the humans everywhere. Even more now with the Darkspawn coming.
I want to say he's an opportunist scoundrel. Regardless of him heavily suggesting that. I do want to know what he means, though. Just to at least give him a second chance.
People flee from the Blight with good reason, but they forget things. Things with value and meaning. They leave them behind because they're frightened and desperate. And sometimes, my boy and I, we find our way to these places before the Horde descends, and we save these things. I take them away so the Darkspawn don't get them. Is that so bad? They destroy everything they touch.
I suppose, yeah, honestly, yeah.
That's what I tell myself, too. Ah, these are dark times, indeed. Dark times, my friend.
All right, honestly?
Ah, yes. I'm married to a fine woman back in Denerim, it's true. She'd give me a son if she could, but that's not likely to ever be. Sandal here. I found him in the deep roads years ago. Abandoned, I think. And he was never quite right in the head. I took him in, and I brought him with me when I came here to the surface. He may not be my blood, true, but I think of him as one.
We left Orzammar.
That's right, boy. Maybe one day we'll see it again. It's not as if I don't benefit, mind you. Turns out the boy's a natural working with enchantments. He might have even been leery-addled. I never thought of that before, to be honest. Happens sometimes. He can work an enchantment into just about anything, however, given some time. Could probably open his own shop, if he knew how.
Enchantment!
Well, he does seem to enjoy it, at least.
Honestly... No, I kind of like how this guy thinks, regardless of what him being a, let's just be real. He's kind of an opportunist scoundrel, but I like the way he thinks about, you know, the Darkspawn not getting anything and all that hoopla.
I'm sure you'll be pleased with the goods my boy and I have collected, and with your discount.
You know, I am kind of sorry that I kind of laughed at, you know, the way he said, enchantments, yes. I know it kind of means well, but let's see. Is that large? These are kidding. Agent, one of the rare family prospect runs. Agent, blah, blah, blah. I'm kind of looking for, what is this? Cold damage, fire damage, longbow belt, dwarven belt. Yeah. Let's see. Crap. Not fine. Okay, kitty cat. Let's see.
Yes. Sitting, as you observed.
Oh, we have jokes now.
No, it's a choice, not a necessity.
Really?
I did. Parshera, was there anything else? Speak, then.
He's seriously one of those characters, isn't he?
Then I suggest we move on. As you wish.
You know, I just want to say,
Yes? Well, here I am.
What? Let's see, what if I... what would someone like you be doing in the Dwarven Enchantry?
What is meant by someone like me? Did you think I was always a cloistered sister? The Chantry provides succor and safe harbor to all who seek it. I chose to stay and become affirmed. I was a traveling minstrel in Orlais. Tales and songs were my life. I performed, and they rewarded me with applause and coin. And my skill in battle? Well, you pick up different skills when you travel, yes? Yes, of course. Let's move on.
Huh. So, basically, she just learned as she went, essentially. Became this decent fighter. Alistair, what do you say?
What do you need? Ask away.
Let's see. Why have you remained a Templar if you hate the Chantry?
Have you seen the uniform? It's not only stylish, but well made. I'm a sucker for good tailoring.
I thought Templars...
That's just in public. In private, we have these yellow and purple tunics, right? Much more comfortable, and you don't break the beds when you jump on them during a pillow fight.
What?
Oh, you know, between all the guilt and the hours spent in solemn prayer, any good Templar or priest is just bursting to tell a few good jokes when the opportunity arises. You don't really want to know about my being a Templar, do you? It's really quite boring.
Well, you don't have to tell me then. I was just curious.
Then let's just get back to what we were doing. No offense, but I'd really rather not discuss it.
Bro. You know what? Fine. Fine. Be that way. Fine. I don't care. Bucky!
Oh, why, you little... Oh, you're so funny. Such rapier wit. Your furry friend here took offense at me getting near his food. He snapped at me. Look.
Good boy. Teach us silly eyes. That was your lesson.
Sometimes I forget that he's a war dog. That'll teach me.
Oh, don't be that way, Alistair. You're such a crybaby, you know that?
Yes.
Indeed.
Yes.
I'll just take those four. Let's see. Now, I did understand that. Now, I do know that I'm supposed to go to the. Let's see, where the Magi is. Is this. No, that's the Lothar. Lothar, but. Forest Dangerous, which one? So, this is party camp. And this hut. Now, I. A friend of mine did say go to the Magi's first and see what they say. And I think Breslin was that? I hope. Oh, what the?
Hello.
The boy's a bit simple, but he's rather good with enchantments. One of those tranquil fellas actually called him a... What was he now? A savant.
Let's see, what do you have to say, Morgan?
What do you wish of me?
I have to ask you something.
If you must.
Yes, I must. How did you become a shapeshifter?
I was not born such. 'Tis a skill of Flemeth's, taught over many years in the wilds. The chastened have tales of we witches,
saying that we assume the forms of creatures to watch them from hiding. When a child is alone and separate from his tribe, that is when we strike, dragging the young boy kicking and screaming to our lair to be devoured. A most amusing legend.
Just a legend, right?
So I assume. My mother has walked the wilds far longer than I. Who am I to suggest what things she has done and not done in her past? Why do you ask? Is there something specific you wish to know?
No, not really.
Anyone with sufficient will. But the act of transformation is a magical one. Tis a spell and thus requires a mage's talents. If you had a notion to learn such a skill for yourself, sadly, you must remain disappointed.
Can you turn into other human forms as well?
The form of an animal is different from my own. One may study the creature, learn to move as it does, think as it does. In time, this allows one to become as it is. I gain nothing by studying another human. I already am the same as they are. I learn nothing. So the answer is no, my human form is the only one I possess.
Do you spend a lot of time as an animal?
There were nights when the wilds called to me, 'tis true. You look upon the world around you and you think you know it well. I have smelled it as a wolf, listened as a cat, prowled shadows that you never dreamed existed. But my life is as a human. I am under no illusions to the contrary.
And what do other animals think when you're changed?
They do not shy away from me. To their senses, I believe I seem like any other of their species. As to what they think, I truly cannot say. Just as I am still human, no matter my form, they are still animals. Thus they cannot speak, even were I to ask.
That's, different.
No, 'tis not unheard of in the remote corners of the world. There are traditions of magic outside of the circle of magi, despite what those mages would have you believe. Some of these traditions are old, indeed, passed down as carefully guarded lore from one generation to the next. The zealots of the Chantry would uproot all such practitioners if they could. But as luck have it, some still exist. My mother is such a one.
So, would that be some sort of... Is that open to abuse?
Not all apostates use the forbidden blood arts. Maleficarum do, but to condemn all who do not fall under the circle's thrall for the sake of what might be is a dangerous path to walk. There are those who look on the word apostate as meaning freedom.
Well, you know, I really can't deny that. I really do like how she thinks.
Indeed. Have you an opinion on my abilities, then? Am I an unnatural abomination to be put to the torch?
I think your abilities are quite useful.
Oh, you're simply full of surprises, little man, aren't you? But enough of such talk, let us proceed lest the dust gather on us.
Let's see if I can...
Yes. Speak, then. Then I suggest we move on. I am hardly surprised. To answer a question. The Arishak asked what is the blight. By his curiosity, I am now here.
Why would the Canary care about the...
Why do you?
Hmm.
Do you think the Kunari live on some other world, then?
No. Did you find the answer to this question?
A portion of it.
Don't you have to report back?
Yes.
So, when are you going to do that?
Never. I cannot go home. It doesn't matter now. Can we move on? We keep the Darkspawn waiting.
Let's go.
As you wish.
Oh well. Didn't mean to upset him, but... Oh well. My bad.
Yes.
That's where I went before, isn't it?
Yes.
What do you have this?
Next to nothing, I'm afraid. Perhaps there is little to know about this space, or I simply have not discovered its secrets yet.
Seriously?
is but one world, one life, one death. There is but one God, and he, the one who repents, who has faith unshaken by the darkness of the world, and roasts not, nor gloats over the misfortunes of the weak, but takes delight in the Maker's law and creations.
Boasts. It's boasts, sister, not roasts.
She shall know the peace of the Maker's benediction. The light shall lead her safely through the paths of this world and into the next.
Peace, sister, peace. She shall know the peace of the Maker's benediction.
The veil holds no uncertainty for her, and she will know no fear of death, for the Maker shall be her bacon and her shield, her foundation and her...
There's no veal in the chant. You're doing this on purpose, aren't you?
Oh. Hello, dear. Can we help you?
What she means is, in Andraste's name, be welcome.
Stop correcting me! What would Andraste do? That's what you should be concerned with, I say. Andraste was no fuss budget.
What?
Tell you about the chart? What? As if it's a cake you might buy? Well, it's done enough, but a little too much nutmeg for my taste.
Sister, instructing the ignorant is a sacred duty of the chantry.
Fine, then. What do you want to know?
What does the chant say about the dark? You know, I'm almost wanting to be a complete smart aleck to this lady. I'm sorry.
Oh, there are some very stirring canticles about doom and wrath.
Darkspawn were created by mankind's second sin, pride. Arrogance became a great caged beast in the lands of Tevinter, an emptiness that consumed all and could never be filled. To satisfy its hunger, the mage lords assaulted the Golden City, heart of all creation, to take the Maker's power for themselves.
Why does no one ever sing the good stanzas during chantry services anymore? They speak them. It's called the chant of light, not the speech of light.
Sister, would you kindly stop messing up the chant?
See how you like being interrupted.
Well, you get the general idea, I'm sure.
Why is there a squirrel here?
It's the 10th stanza from the Transfigurations. Lovely canticle, that one. Oh, you should have heard Brother Cademan sing it, though.
You sing it well, I take it.
He had a voice like a bucket full of toads. Revered Mother Boanne, bless her heart, always said, if we had more voices like his, the Maker couldn't fail to take note of us.
What happened to him?
It was tragic, really. Such a surprise.
We don't speak of that.
He died?
He was in charge of the Lyrium storehouse. It wasn't good for him, you see. He took off all his clothes in the middle of the chant one summer day and ran into the street. He tripped and fell into the vat of elderberry wine for the feast and drowned. We were 6 days drying him out for his cremation. He looked like a pickled egg. So tragic.
I am so sorry. I know that shouldn't be funny, but that really is kind of tragic how it happened, but...
It is almost mealtime, isn't it?
Blessings of the Maker and of Andraste, his bride, upon you.
Yeah, he ended up looking like a pickled egg. Couldn't live with him, couldn't live without him. We couldn't kill him at that point. I know I shouldn't be loud.
The deep dark before dawn's first light seems eternal.
Am I mission is in action. Let's see. Recently, our hearts were lifted when the survivors, blah, blah, blah. Logan's push. Let's see. Continuing. While it is unusual to post troop movements in the public board, I believe it is necessary for the Brethren near affected area to respect the honor Tyrion aiding his troops. Provide whatever comfort you feel they deserve, and Ferelden will be stronger for it. Treat the brave soldiers as you would treat Logan himself. Oh, you mean like with a punch in the face, right? Might as well.
But know that the sun always rises.
Magic exists to serve man and never to rule over him. Foul and corrupt are they who have taken his gift and turned it against his children.
They shall be named Malefica.
Okay, so. Who is he? Who's this?
You're the Grey Warden, aren't you? Exactly who I was hoping to meet. I represent a collective of mages interested in going about their lives without the constant scrutiny of the Chantry.
Oh? Isn't that against Chantry laws?
We harm no one, I assure you. And we enforce the Chantry's laws among ourselves. All we seek is a life outside of the Templar's shadow. Next to me, and in every major settlement, you will find an inconspicuous sack containing requests from mages all over the land who need the assistance of someone skillful and discreet. Me? I am not a mage, my friend. And those members who have submitted requests are anonymous. Save one or two more arrogant clients. I assure you, we are doing the Maker's work. Magic is not ruling man under our watch. Thank you, my friend. We have agents in every major settlement to reward you for work done on behalf of the collective. Makers smile upon you.
Let's see. So basically.
All right.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Returning collective news of his whereabouts. You know, I'll go ahead and take care of that. Logan's push. Let's see. Wooden crate.
Yes.
Yeah, might as well. Courier.
Leave me to my business.
Thank you. I had business for you, but nope, not now.
You here to report another crime? I swear we should just cordon off the entire district. Oh, can I help you, Warden?
Is it Market District or
the part? Lower Market isn't deemed important by the Captain of the Guard, even less with Arl Howe in charge. So when I finally get the new men I request, I get the delightful surprise of discovering their Lord such and such as illegitimate, untrained, moronic whelps. But lords keep sending me more of them. It's decent pay, no expectations, a uniform. So I have a legion of bastards to protect the market from pickpockets, stabbings, and whatnot, and Arl Howe's specially picked men are the worst of the lot.
How do you know who I am?
Your likeness was passed around to the senior guardsman at the palace. I must say, the sketch didn't do you much justice. Don't worry. Even if I believed the official story of what happened at Ostagar, I'm no fool. If I asked my men to apprehend you, they'd all run and cry big sobby tears in their courtesans' bosoms and leave me all alone to be skewered. Don't disturb the peace in the market, and that's well enough for me.
I actually do need help?
To what? You're serious? I mean, yes, yes, I could use help. I've got a pretty popular establishment that's crawling with mercenaries. Uh-huh. If I send my boys in, someone might get, maker forbid, hurt, and I'll have to explain to their noble fathers that being a guard is actually dangerous.
What's the pay?
Do a good job and I'll see you get some silver in your pockets, maybe even some gold.
What do you need me to do?
The name of the whorehouse is the Pearl. Beat down any mercenaries that are out of line and send them a message. I said beat down, not kill. Let me make that really clear. Not on fire, or exploded, or make a nose, whatever type of grisly death you can dream up. Sorry. Used to giving orders to my boys. Just leave them breathing and I'll be happy. Thank you, Warden. Happy hunting.
So, basically, you find a pearl in the Pearl Brothel down by the docks district. See the map. Enchantment. So I'm guessing it's down
those
this way?
Those are too small. The dogs were yelping all night long. Smell of the docks.
Sorry, this... That's one outside, isn't it?
By order of the new Earl of Denerim, no one is to enter the alienage. There's been an elven uprising. Nyfears even have the gall to attack the Earl's only son. Killed him in cold blood. With the whole Urien family dead, the regent appointed Rendon Howe of Amaranthine the new Earl of Denerim. First thing he did was lead a purge of the alienage. It's a mess in there. When things are put back in order, the gates will be reopened. Now on your way.
Excuse me, do you even know who I am? Piece of crap. Let's see, what's in the tavern? Oh, it's just a barrel.
What can I get you, stranger?
Have you heard any rumors?
I hear tell they held a funeral in Denerim for King Kaelin. The Grand Cleric called for a full day of mourning and there was a procession a mile long passing by the brazier. It's too bad they don't have a body to properly burn. What happened to him at the hands of those creatures, it's unthinkable. Anything else you need?
Heard any other rumors?
I hear the Dwarven King is passed on. Old as he was probably poisoned or assassinated. That's how the dwarves normally go out, isn't it? Anything else you need?
Let me see what you have.
Right, I'll show you around.
Ale? Huh. I think that's enough for now.
What can I get you, stranger?
Negotiation A. Okay, request the fine. Deliver a stack of 15 toxin extract samples to the well-connected bartender and the not noble in Demirian for Kay.
Allow me.
I could do that for you.
Oh.
On my way.
Whatever. Sophie's guard.
My shift's nearly over. Think I'm trusting.
Welcome to the wonders of Thedas. We carry items crafted by the Circle, as well as a variety of antiquities. Is there anything you would like to see?
Let's see, Bruce's voice. I can't do much of anything here. God dang it.
I recognize you. From Ostagar. And trust his blood. You're a Grey Warden. Duncan's apprentice. You killed my friend. And good King Caelan. I demand satisfaction, sir.
Yeah.
I am a knight of Ferelden. Your threats do not deter me, sir. An uncommon traitor deserves no common death. We will meet on the field of honor, and my blade shall see justice done. Meet me in the back alley behind the Nord Noble Tavern. There we will duel. So you would compound slander on top of treason? You dare smear Terran Loghain's word?
Yes, I do. Yeah, we would never help the Darkspawn.
Do not try to worm your way out of it, traitor. In the back alley, we will duel.
Oh my god.
Dwarven crap. Buying dwarven crap.
What an idiot.
Are you ready? I am no savage. I would not take advantage of you.
I see us at full. Get him.
You coward!
Ah!
Something. Part of me says I want to feel sorry for him, but the other part of me pretty much says the guy was a fool. Like, legit.
Dwarven crafts. Fine dwarven crafts. Direct from Orzammar. You won't find better.
On my way.
Dwarven crafts. Fine dwarven crafts. Direct from Orzammar. You won't find better. Welcome. Welcome. We sell only the strongest dwarven steel, folded over 100 times in the forges of Orzammar. In times like this, surely your group could use some extra protection on the road. I'll answer what I can, but my policy is not to sell things that don't belong to me.
What's happening in the city right now?
The Landsmeet's the big news. Every dusty noble estate in Denerim is airing its sheets, waiting for the Lord to ride into town.
Who are some important people?
It's the capital of Ferelden, so naturally the Queen and Regent are at the top. But the man who seems to be running the city guard is the new Arl Rendon Howe. Came in from somewhere up north. The Landsmeet's the big news. Okay. Every dusty noble estate in Denerim is airing its sheets. Every piece comes with a stamp of assurance from my wife's father, the best smith in Denerim.
Really? That's honestly intriguing. You know, I'm gonna go ahead and equip a few things. Yeah, great shards are dual woven, right? Yeah, two-handed. Armor. Are you serious? There's nothing here that... Wow, that looks so off on her.
Okay.
If you guys seriously have any tips or whatever, just let me know in the comments below. Seriously, I want to hear what you guys have to say about this. Okay, Shane is 22 strength. So, what about him? Might as well give that to him for now.
Allow me. I could do that for you.
Dwarven craft. Find dwarven craft. Direct from Orzammar. Won't find better.
Caesar.
If you have coin, welcome to our shop. If not, move along. Too many refugees blocking customers.
About
near? Better trade cities to the north, but plenty good trade here. Now with war and blight, business is bad.
Anything for sale?
Oh, yes.
You know, okay, I would love to buy some of this stuff. I'm like poor as all heck, so yeah. So, who are you? Hey, wait, your watch is for you, aren't you?
Right away.
Ah!
Welcome, friends. Welcome to Wade's Emporium. We have the finest armors in Denerim, maybe in all of Ferelden. How may we assist you?
Could you tell me about the city?
The city is full to bursting. With people from the country coming, trade is thriving. Especially those that deal in weapons and armor. Master Wade is especially in demand.
Tell me about Wade.
You're obviously not from around here. Wade is possibly the most brilliant armorsmith in all of Ferelden.
That's not true, Herin. The dwarves of Orzammar make the finest armors around. These piles of rust droppings you force me to make are worthless compared to their work. You never let me have the time, the materials to make something special.
Customers expect their armor in a timely fashion, not years late like the last time.
That happened once, just once, and you never let it draw.
Who's in charge here?
I am.
Wade owns the Emporium, but without expert assistance and, well, prodding. Let's just say the Emporium has improved substantially with our partnership.
But I do miss the good old days. I could really take my time to make quality.
Oh, by all means, you can return to them. And to the gruel you used to fancy.
No, no. Sorry, Herin.
Well then, they seem to have a good friendship.
Certainly.
You know what, frick this. I'm done with them for now.
Why are you here?
Excuse me?
Obviously you are no priestess, but shouldn't you be running a shop or a farm somewhere rather than fighting?
You think to tell me my place, Kunari? You are very brave.
It is not done.
But it is done. Do not be such a blind fool.
I speak the truth. It is not I who is blind.
Look around you then. You see women throughout this land, fighters and mages both.
That has yet to be proven.
Which, that they fight, or that they are female?
Either.
So I am not truly a woman to you. Hmm? It is good to know.
Yes.
Okay. I see where their friendship lies, and it's very, very weird. Yeah, definitely weird.
Good day. The market is busy, is it not? Come, rest here. I have the finest selection of flowers and Orlesian scented oils in all of Denerim. For a lady friend, perhaps? Roses can open any woman's heart, you know.
What's there to see in this market?
Much of the city is still a mystery to me, but the market is like my home. Circle and sorceled objects can be found in the wonders of Thedas, in the alleyway north. The armorer, Wade, and his emporium are just to the south. If you need work, outside the rectory to the southeast is a chanter's board. And if your thirst is strong, head to the Nord Noble Tavern north of here. Be prepared, though. They do put on many airs.
Where are you from?
I am from Orlais. You've heard of us, no? Your Denerim is a fine city, but I miss my Varroyo. She's quite beautiful this time of year.
Why did you leave?
Orlais has many, many good things, but it is sometimes not so good to be common. My brother had trouble with a chevalier, and we departed shortly after.
What's a chevalier?
A chevalier took an interest in me. It was his right, but it was unwelcome. Incensed, my brother hit him over the head with a pot. Such a thing is almost treason. We left that very night and came here. That and more. Some revere them for their skill and their high service, but others tread lightly. As lightly as the mouse in the cat's den. If you will excuse me, I feel a touch lightheaded.
Okay. Bye.
Turn your attention elsewhere. My business does not concern you. Thank you and farewell.
I punch you in the face for that.
Dwarven crafts. Find dwarven crafts. Wreck from Orzammar.
Jarred.
So how is it the Terran Loghain survived when even the Grey Wardens didn't make it out of that place down south? I hear there isn't even... Best be careful. Darkspawn are coming.
So I'm trying to find the, Alright guys, I think I'm just gonna save right here. If you guys know where was this? Oh, nothing here. Jeez. If you guys have any tips or tricks, like tell me what to do or whatever. Please post it in the comments below. And thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you all in the next episode. Bye-bye!